clouds moved quickly like the rhinos and James in the Giant Peach. As she approached with her orange oversized bag that made me think about the circus. Her complimentary oversized supersized umbrella covered us both as she sat on the bench next to me. I'd already been cussed out by my mom 6 times and I wasn't looking to get to the 7th. Swinging my feet no umbrella as the rain poured down, my mother paced. Strangers avoided eye contact as the tense glances from my mother let them know they better not even try to speak up for me. I sat at the LAX bus center terminal looking at the planes, thinking about how riding one must be so different than watching from the ground. Heart pounding, my jokes weren't working this day. My smiles couldn't overcome the internal battles that raged in my mother's eyes. Tired, heavy heart, yet joy at the thoughts that flowed through my elementary school mind about what animals might pop out. I looked over at her, the lady with the oversized jumbo orange bag, and whispered, "Really cool bag." She looked at me perplexed, as if she hadn't noticed I'd been sitting next to her in my seat swinging my feet. My mother quickly approached, still enraged by the mental battles that continued to swirl, and told me I needed to be quiet because nobody wanted to hear my annoying voice have me ask my idiotic questions. I closed my eyes to prevent the tears that had sat on my heart from falling. I knew if my mother saw the tears, she would produce the line she loved. "Stop crying before I give you something to cry about." Suspended in the impending waterfalls of tears that began to reach the edge, the woman with the large orange oversized bag and supersized umbrella said, "You hold tight to your light, baby girl. No matter who tries to dim it, fight to find the joy." The clouds didn't open. The sun didn't shine. In fact, the words shared made my mother's anger rise. Yet, no matter what the next actions would happen, I knew in that moment the seed had already been planted. Fight for joy and cling to the light. The seed had been planted in the dark moments, and the clouds are like rhinos. You're watching people take off as you stand looking up in the sky. You don't let anyone cover your light. I held to light by keeping my heart close and my head filled with hope. Hope that one day things would be different. I would take actions to be different. I decided in that moment that when the day came for me to be a grown-up, I would speak up. I wouldn't turn a blind eye or be too afraid to step in and remind those who were in situations like me to not only keep the hope, but to stand with the heart as a beacon of light by standing up for what's right. Through the years, the fight for joy has been overwhelming, and sometimes I've lost my grip, yet in overwhelm, I've still found ways to cling to the light. No matter what they say, don't let them make you forget that your light is irreplaceable. In your heart, no matter those who try to break it down, is formidable. And you are going to change the world.